Welcome back to Sledgehammer Horror, guys. I am Ken Sledge, and let's talk horror. Today, I am joined by writer and producer Adam Stephen Kelly. How you doing, my friend?
I'm very well, thank you. How are you?
I'm doing very well. I've been excited about this all day. Adam has been a very busy guy since the age of 16. He was writing for Rolling Stone, GQ, and Ain't It Cool News. From there, he went on to write the award-winning short film Done In, and more recently writing the action thriller Kill Kane and the upcoming crime thriller Nemesis, which should be dropping relatively quickly, right?
Yeah, so that's out in the UK on March 29th, and it'll be out in the US later this year.
Awesome. Any updates you have about that, please give them to me and I'll be happy to share them with everybody. Or you guys don't have to wait for me. I have Adam's links down here in the description. Make sure you're giving him a follow so you can stay up to date on it. So what can you tell us a little bit about Nemesis? Non-spoiler, obviously, so we can get a little more excited for the film.
Yeah, absolutely. So Nemesis is ultimately it's a home invasion movie. It's a crime drama about a businessman, well, gangster, who is living abroad, living overseas, and he returns to London for business purposes. And when he's back in London, he meets his old nemesis, effectively. This guy has a serious axe to grind. And now that this character, John Morgan, is back in London, this gives opportunity for Frank Conway to get his revenge. And whilst all that's going on, there is other forces conspiring against John Morgan. And it all comes to a head in this apartment block, in this penthouse apartment, where there's, you know, no space, nowhere to go. And that's where the home invasion element comes into it. So it's a nice mix of things. You've kind of got the horror element with the home invasion. You've got the gangster stuff there's quite a lot to this one.
Yeah, I'm very, very excited. It's something that we've talked about a little bit, and I've always been a big fan of gangster films, Casino, you know, Goodfellas, that's what I grew up with. And obviously horror movies and the thriller aspect of it. So it's something I'm very, very excited about. And then Kill Kane is another action thriller that's already out. A little bit about Kill Kane. What can you tell us about that?
So Kill Kane was a film I did in 2015, came out in 2016. And that is, as you say, that's a crime thriller, another gangster movie with Vinnie Jones in the lead role for that one. And that's again, like Nemesis, has a home invasion element to it. It's about a family man who is played by Vinnie Jones, who sees something he shouldn't, a gangland execution just happens upon him. And the gang that were involved in this execution spot him, and then they go after him and put his family through a pretty terrible ordeal. And the bulk of the movie is about him getting his revenge on these people and becoming sort of the antithesis of what he is at the beginning of the film, which is this family man.
Right. Well, as a father myself, I can totally understand if anything were to happen, trying to get revenge for your family.
Yeah, absolutely. So it was an interesting role for Vinnie Jones, I think, because he was playing, you know, almost against type to start the movie off. People seeing him in a different light to what he normally plays, and then of course the rest of the film is him getting his bloody revenge, which is I think more what that fans of Vinnie Jones were, you know, sort of after. So
No, and I'm so excited. Like I said, I got all the links down in the description, guys, so you can check this stuff out. Is Kill Kane streaming anywhere that we can check it out? Or
so I think in the US it's on Amazon Prime, available for streaming. I think generally it's available pretty much everywhere in the States and in the UK as well. It's on Amazon Prime, DVD, pretty much everything, which is always nice.
Awesome. And best of luck with Nemesis, man. I'm very excited to check that out when it comes out. Like I said, any updates, please send them my way. If you get a release date for the US, I'd love to be able to share it. And everybody else, I know I said it at the beginning, but I want to throw that reminder out there. His links are down here in the description, so you don't have to wait on me. You can follow him and get the updates from the horse's mouth. So we talked to Adam about what's going on in the future with Nemesis. We talked about some of the things that you've already done, but I want to take it back to the past, my friend. I want to talk horror with you for a little bit. I want to know where that started. The first horror movie you watched, and your first horror movie was?
Jaws.
What an amazing first horror movie, man.
I like it. Yeah, so Jaws was the first horror movie I ever watched, and it's subsequently become my favorite film of all time. So I think having that initial viewing when I was a kid and having that initial fear instilled in me all those years later, I think just kind of had such an effect on me that it's just become, you know, my absolute favorite movie. And I love just revisiting that. It's like watching it for the first time all over again, even though I know the script backwards.
It's Jaws is one of those movies that is so influential in so many different ways. And it's one of those movies where there's so many different things that can attract you to this film. Do you remember how old you were the first time you had seen it?
Don't remember exactly how old I was, but I would have to say probably 5 years old, because my brother, I have a brother who's 9 years older than me, and his favorite film is also Jaws. So he would watch it, and he would sort of drag me into the living room to watch this movie. And all I would need to hear is the John Williams theme, and I would just be it just terrified me. Just the music alone, let alone a 26-foot great white shark coming out of the water. So it just used to absolutely terrify me as a kid. So I imagine I would have been sort of about 5 years old the first time I saw it.
And Jaws definitely has one of the best scores of all time. I mean, people that have never seen Jaws know that Kevin everybody knows that, even if they've never seen the film. That's how influential the score itself is. Now, again, we talked about how this movie especially has so many scenes that are so influential to a lot of different people. Do you remember which scene affected you the most?
Absolutely. So there's a scene in the early part of the movie where there's this little kid, sort of 6-7-year-old kid by the name of Alex Kintner, and he's just having fun in the water on a little inflatable raft or whatever you want to call it. And he becomes a victim to the shark, and you know, he's just a kid, but you know, 1975, and they absolutely didn't waste any time in showing you an extremely graphic death that's still graphic today. I mean, you're literally seeing a young kid getting ripped to pieces by a shark and blood sort of pulsating out the water. Very graphic even by today's standards. And I think it's amazing looking back to think that Jaws was a PG when it came out. When there's so much like genuine terror, and there's, you know, decapitated heads, there's dismembered limbs, kids being eaten. It's crazy. I mean, in the UK, it was originally a PG. And over here we have the BBFC is the ratings board, mm-hmm. and we have U, which is universal, which means anyone can see something. Then there's PG, which is obviously the same as anywhere else. And then we have a 12 certificate. So you have to be, you know, 12 or over, and then 15 and 18. And Jaws is one of those films that actually the rating was reviewed all those years later, and it's now a 12. So it's funny looking back at a movie that was made in 1975, was a PG. And years later, they thought, actually, that's a bit too strong for the PG rating.
I think when that came out, especially in the States, I think they had just PG and then R. I don't think they had a PG-13 at that point when this movie came out. But I think you're right. This is one of those movies that had to be on the border of PG and R when they were reviewing it.
Yeah, exactly. And it's funny. I mean, I see so many people just sort of describe Jaws as like a thriller or an adventure movie. And it has those elements in it. But there seems to be like a bit of an argument between people about what Jaws is. Is it an actual horror movie? And I think, damn right, it's a horror movie. I mean, it's there's so many horrific elements in it, as I've just said. So it's definitely a horror movie. But I think it's one that's, as I say, certainly terrified me as a kid, and has given me like a lifelong fear of water, in a sense. Like, I don't go in the sea, and it's because of Jaws. I just don't do it. And when I was younger, I used to have a swimming pool in the backyard, and there was a mosaic at the bottom of it of a dolphin, and I would never swim alone, even in the pool, because suddenly when I'm a young kid, that mosaic dolphin is now, it's a 26-foot great white shark. So no, I always had to be accompanied to the pool.
And that was one of those, you're going to need a bigger pool.
Exactly, yes. A pool without a mosaic in it that would freak me out.
And Jaws is another thing that the one-liners in this movie are absolutely great too. And a lot of them were just, you know, on the spot, like when they're drinking in the boat, like that was just ad-libbed a lot of it. And when you think of Jaws, what is the first thing that pops into your head?
I mean, the first thing that pops into my head is the shark, just because it's just so iconic. And I think it looks, I mean, people watch it today and they say, oh, the shark looks fake, but I think it looks awesome. I still love the way it looks. It's just such an iconic movie monster. So that's immediately the first thing I think of. But like you say, there's so many qualities to that film, from, like you say, the dialogue and it's such a quotable film. I mean, everyone knows.
You're going to need a bigger boat.
But there's so much more to it than that. And so many amazing character moments as well. I mean, between the main three characters, there's just so much there. And I think Roy Scheider's performance is one of those, I think, ultimately underrated performances, because there's so much to it, and there's so many sort of nuances to his performance and things that, I mean, just him being like a clumsy guy who just bangs into everything and hits his head, like it's so much subtle stuff that a lot of people don't even pick up on. But there's just so much there.
Like you said, you're going to need a bigger boat. And one of my favorite movie quotes of all time is the,
"Smile, you son of a..."
That's one of those endlessly rewatchable ones.
Yes. So we're talking about, you know, quotes and dialogues and scenes. I know which one affected you the most, but now I'd like to know, what is your favorite scene from Jaws?
It's a good question. That's very difficult one. It's my favorite movie of all time, and every scene to me is golden. That's a very good question. I don't know, to be honest. I mean, I would have to say probably the stuff when they're out to sea on the Orca, and they're firing the barrels and trying to hunt the shark. Because there's, you know, you've got this, throughout the bulk of the movie, you've got this shark effectively attacking Amity Island. You think everyone's safe on land, and then suddenly these three guys are far out to sea, and you think maybe they're even safe on this boat, but they're not, and they've got nowhere to go to. The engine's dead. They're just floating effectively, and now all of them are potential victims of this shark. And so I think when they start the hunt for the shark and use the barrels and everything, it's just a really thrilling scene and totally iconic because of the, you know, the barrels popping up out of the water, and you can't see the shark, but you know it's there because you're following the barrels, and it's just
right,
very, very thrilling.
And it's great because they had so many mechanical issues with the different sharks that I think it actually worked out in favor of the movie, because you don't see the shark as much. So a lot of it is left to your imagination. And to me, that's so much scarier when I got to use my imagination rather than having something just in your face all the time. So now I'm going to go a little dark on you here, Adam. We talked about your favorite scene. Now, which kill would you say is your favorite kill from the movie?
Favorite kill. I would have to go back to the Alex Kidner scene, I think, just because it is so disturbing and it's so just in your face raw, and there's no, I mean, you know, killing a kid in a movie is one thing, but actually most movies will shy away from actually showing it, and right. Jaws shows you pretty much everything, and that scene's always just ingrained in my head, since I was a kid, just that particular scene. So I think that would be my favorite kill, even though, as I say, it's the death of a child, but it's
right.
It's so effective. And again, even today, it really holds up as something that's genuinely unsettling.
I think scary. A lot of Jaws, it holds up today. And something I've talked about a lot, not just Jaws, but Texas Chainsaw Massacre and The Ring are other films that I put in this. I wish that these would have been standalone films. I don't think that you needed to have Jaws 2, Jaws 3, Jaws the Revenge. Those are unnecessary films to me. Jaws was the perfect standalone film. That's all you needed was Jaws. You didn't have to continue this on. So before I let you go, my friend, we always end these with the same question. We're talking about Jaws and we're talking about a skull count. Now, what we're doing is we're going to rank Jaws, 0 being the worst, 5 being the best. And I'm pretty sure I know the answer, but I always got to ask. Now, we're not ranking this. We're not being critics here. We're not ranking it on production, acting, any of the quality. We're ranking it just on what it means to you and how it affected you as a kid. So ranking Jaws, 0 skulls being the worst, 5 being the best. What is your skull ranking of Jaws, my friend?
Easiest question you've asked today. 5. Definitely 5. It's a film that's deeply affected me, and it's also a film that's definitely shaped me wanting to become a filmmaker. And having it's to me, it's like a really magical film because it's something that I grew up on. It's something from my childhood. And I think it really shaped me as wanting to do something that had a similar effect on people. Wanted me to create stuff that people would get a reaction from and connect with. That's the goal, at least. So I think that's a staple film in not only my life, but also my career. So it's a very important movie to me. So definite 5, easy.
And like you said, this isn't a movie that is just a horror movie. It's not just a thrill. This movie has so many different elements of different genres in it. And it's to me, it's one of the perfect movies out there. There's slow parts and, there is no such thing as the perfect movie, but this is a movie I can watch no matter what mood I'm in. No matter what time of day, I could always throw this movie on and be absolutely happy that it's on.
Exactly. There's so many elements to it. It's a horror movie, but it isn't just a horror movie. There's so many different aspects. So it doesn't matter what mood you're in. I'm always in the mood for Jaws. So.
Yeah, I totally agree with you. Well, man, I do appreciate you coming on. Don't go anywhere, Adam. I got a couple more questions for you. Everybody else, like I said, make sure you're clicking the links down here in the description, giving him a follow. As always, I'm Ken Sledge. Keep talking horror, stay what you are, and we'll see you guys soon.